Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, we come today to celebrate the feast of the two apostles of our Lord, Saints Philip and James, and James the Less, not the greater one. And also today, my dear brothers and sisters, is the first Friday of the month, and we remember our devotion to the Sacred Heart of Jesus, the overflowing and immense love of God is real for all of us. And we are all blessed, my dear brothers and sisters, with the love of God. We have the apostles to guide us in our Christian faith and solidify our belief in Him. Philip, in our gospel today, was mentioned several times in the scriptures about the call of Nathanael, the multiplication of the loaves, and the request of some Greeks who wanted to see Jesus. And today's gospel, in which Philip voices the longing we all have to see the Father. We have James also, the son of Alphaeus, which distinguishes from the other James, who is the son of Zebedee. James the Lesser became the first bishop of Jerusalem. And these two apostles that we celebrate today, the proclaimer of the good news of our Lord. My dear brothers and sisters, being an apostle is to spread and to proclaim the good news. An apostle does not proclaim message of his own. They hands on what they receive and experience. That is why Saint Paul, in our first reading of today, summarizes for us the basic message that Christ died for our sins in accordance with the scripture, that he was buried and he was raised on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. This is our Christian faith, mother, brothers, and sisters. This is the gospel, the good news of which Jesus Christ that we have and we receive in our lives. And this is what we are sent out to give to others, to proclaim the good news, to proclaim our Christian faith in our lives by our words, by our actions, and our whole way of life. And my dear brothers and sisters, we can say now, we are so blessed, or we are all fortunate, because we are given the very good direction to take on every day. We possess the Spirit of truth to embrace. We live in His presence and living out the very words of Jesus that we heard in the first part of our gospel today, that He is the way, the truth, and the life. He assured for all of us today, mother, brothers, and sisters, to have a living, to live a complete existence, to have complete life in our daily life. Apparently, mother, brothers, and sisters, by this living out the direction, the truth, and the life that the Lord entrusted to us every day, we see and experience God concretely in our lives. In our gospel today, Philip, in our gospel passage, shows us having an attitude, not being convinced about the equality of the Son and the Father, Jesus and our Father. He demands, siya'y nagtanong at humingi kay Jesus, "Master, show us the Father, and that is enough for all of us." Jesus, my dear brothers and sisters, responded very straightforward answer to Philip. "I have been with you for so long a time, and you still do not know me, Philip?" Anong sinasabi ng ating Panginoon? Palagi niyo akong kasama sa matagal na panahon. Ngayon, hinihiling mo pa rin itong makita ang ating Ama, ang aking Ama. Jesus in our Father, the Son is in the Father, is one, my dear brothers and sisters. Jesus explained with a heart to Philip. Hindi pinagalitan si Felipe sa kanyang hinihiling kay Jesus. Jesus answered with heart to the Philip demand, and even for all of us today, that His presence, His words, His action is one with the Father. When we put our trust in Jesus, when we put our heart to Jesus, all of this goes to the Father. Embracing and loving Jesus, mother, brothers, and sisters, is also doing the same to our loving Father. So therefore, what is the invitation for all of us and a challenge for all of us today? Let us reveal Jesus and our actions as a proof of knowing Him in our lives. And always remember, He is the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Truly, mother, brothers, and sisters, if we want to live well and remarkably in our lives, don't ignore and be convinced of the Spirit of our God given for all of us individually, as a family, as one community in our daily journey here on earth. His revelation is always in our midst, palaging buhay, palaging totoo, palaging nandyan ang Diyos sa atin. His resurrection, ang kanyang muling pagkabuhay, is always our reminder that we have life to gain. Mayroon tayong buhay. Dahil ang buhay natin, ito'y mula sa Diyos. Ang buhay natin araw-araw, ito'y kaugnay sa ating Panginoon. And this time, at present, our life is the same life of God. Truly, we are all expected. Whatever we do, whatever we behave, whatever we say, that is hopefully the image of our Father, the image of our God that we possess in our lives. Indeed, mother, brothers, and sisters, doing so, we have life for eternity. Amen.